Soto went 3-for-5, scored 2 runs, drove in 4 runs, a 922 OPS that he has this season. And I was discussing this with someone next to me at the Padres game today about Juan Soto. It's like, his OPS is so impressive. And this is considering, it's more impressive when you consider what happened earlier on in the season. If you look at his splits for this season, remember that slow start that he got off to and he was rolling over every ball, a bunch of ground balls to second base, not coming through, nowhere near enough, you know, especially for like the Juan Soto expectations, right? I did a breakdown on what the heck is wrong with the swing. I think that was after that Cubs series at Wrigley in Chicago. It's like, there's something wrong here. And if you go look at the splits by month, I mean, he started off this season terribly. He hit 202. He had a 757 OPS in April and March combined. The first 29 games for him, he was hitting 202. And now, well, in September this year so far, he's hitting 329. So he's hot, obviously, right now. But yeah, like starting this season, 757 OPS. Then he had an amazing month of May, 1114 OPS, had a OPS over 900 in June and July, but then he had a bad August, 713 OPS. But then he has a OPS over 1,000 this month, excuse me. So with Soto, kind of like with the Padres, it's just been up and down with him. And so, yeah, I would probably consider this a disappointing season for Juan Soto. And that's going into a walk year next year. That's not someone that I want to part with. You know, not making the postseason this year, I think he's going to be motivated going into next year. And obviously, you know, the free agency thing, the money dangling in front of him, he's right there. He's going to want to perform better than he ever has next season. So that's not someone, and I guarantee you, if the Padres front office is going to be having those conversations this offseason about Juan Soto, should we trade him? Should we not? I guarantee you it's going to be brought up in that front office from someone that if there's someone on it, like one side of the table that's saying trade Juan Soto, we'll still have a talented team. You can get something back for him. We're not going to give him $500 million in free agency, blah, blah, blah. There's going to be someone on that other side saying, hey, Blake Snell, you know that year that he just had for the Padres, Cy Young season? Do you want that for Juan Soto? Do you want to have that guy on the Padres next year? Do you think that the other guys around Juan Soto are going to be that bad this next season? I think we want that Juan Soto on this Padres team. At least give it a chance. That's where I stand on this. At least give it a chance. Having Juan Soto, who's on track for the Hall of Fame, right? He was compared to Ted Williams hitting-wise, right? Earlier on in his career with the Nats. That's not a guy that I want to trade. And only at the end of the day here with the Padres, get one pennant race out of them. When the goal was to get 3, obviously you can't get 3 because there's going to be no postseason opportunity this year. But I want to at least try to get 2. If it's not working at the trade deadline next year, I get it. Like you wouldn't get nearly as much because it would be a rental. But you're telling me that no team would want Juan Soto at the trade deadline next year? Of course they would. Even if he's not playing that well, of course they would, because they'd take the chance because it's Juan Soto, because those teams would know the talent is in there. Again, like just Soto on a free agent year, that really is appealing to have him and just start the season with Juan Soto and see how it goes. And, you know, I mean, if he walks, then he walks, and yeah, that would suck, but at least you tried. At least you tried all of the years with Juan Soto. You gave up that much. You're not going to get that much back if you trade him this offseason, right? So again, I would just try it. And Peter Seidler, he's not getting any younger. Obviously, hoping the best and hoping that he is continuing to recover from the medical procedure that he had. But he's not getting, like, I think he's at the point where he's like, no, I'm just going to continue going all in on this thing because I don't know how much longer I have left. And am I going to regret this? Allowing my front office to trade Juan Soto? Because what if, you know, there's a what if that you can bring up. What if the Padres are a couple games out of a playoff spot and you don't have Juan Soto and he's tearing it up for another team that you traded him to, right? Or what if the Padres made it to the postseason? What if they made it to the NLCS and you've got some other outfielder up in a clutch situation? It's like, dang, we could have had Juan Soto up here. We didn't give it that chance. We didn't try for that, you know, that third season with Soto. We didn't try to get that second kind of, you know, that second postseason World Series chance with Juan Soto, right? Soto in a free agent in a walk here, I want that opportunity. And we might look back on it and be like, dang, they wasted Juan Soto's final year. If it works out like this year and they don't trade him at the deadline, they don't make the postseason next year, we got big problems if they don't make the postseason next year again and have another really disappointing season, obviously, right? Because like this year with Snell, I feel like we wasted Snell's season because they didn't trade him before the deadline. And the team just didn't win. And he's going to win the Cy Young and probably go leave and join another team. It just doesn't feel amazing, you know, with Blake Snell in a Padres uniform this season. And so, yeah, we could feel that same thing with Juan Soto for next year. But I still want to give it that opportunity because I still believe in the core talent on this team. And I believe in Juan Soto performing really well at the plate in a walk here. That's what I believe in. So I'd give it a shot.